मेक इट क्लियर, वी नेवर ट्रीट द बैकग्राउंड. बैकग्राउंड तो ऑलमोस्ट सबको ही मिल जाता है, बहुत लोगों को मिलता है. वी नेवर ट्रीट, वी जस्ट कीप देम ऑन फॉलो अप. एंड व्हाट डू वी एडवाइज देम? कंट्रोल, कंट्रोल. ओके, हैव अ वेरी स्ट्रिक्ट कंट्रोल ऑफ डायबिटीज, वेरी स्ट्रिक्ट कंट्रोल. ठीक है, सो दैट द चेंजेस मे गो बैक, दे डोंट प्रोग्रेस टू योर प्रोलिफरेटिव टाइप. बट वी नेवर ट्रीट बैकग्राउंड. Is that okay? So, question, what is the treatment of choice for PDR? PRP. The treatment of choice for PDR is PRP. Clear? What is the treatment of choice for TRD? Surgery. PPV. Okay. Everybody is aware of these short forms? Treatment of choice for tractional retinal detachment is pars plana vitrectomy. Very good. So, all are fully achieved by 6 months except. Very good. So, answer is the size of the cornea, because it is fully developed by 2 years. Okay? Very good. So, if I ask you, when does the fusional reflex starts? Fusional reflex. How, when is the ability to fusion, to fuse start? At around second to third week, fusion starts. And it is completed by two to three months. It is completed by 2 to 3 months. Later comes stereopsis. Stereopsis is the last to come. Okay? Very good. So what is the size of a neonate's eye? 16 millimeters. What is the size of neonate's cornea? 9 millimeters. What is the term megalocornea? More than 13 mm. What is microcornea? Kya baat hai yaar. Very good. Bacche pad ke aaye hain, hai na? Ye which test is this number? First test. This is your first test. You have done with ENT?
Yes.
Achha, sabka nahi hua hai. Few of you. Good. Haan ji. Not a feature of fungal ulcer? Corneal vascularization. In fungal ulcers, there's never a vascularization. Please write down. There is never a vascularization and there is never a perforation. They never perforates and there is no vascularization also. Especially in fungal ulcers. Question number 23, not true regarding episcleritis. Answer is D. Now let's see what is the episcleritis and how do you differentiate it from a scleritis. So guys, as the name suggests, epi means bahar, outside. Outside the sclera, we have a conjunctiva. Now the space between the conjunctiva and the sclera is your episcleral space. Is that okay? So there is a superficial congestion, superficial inflammation. Everything is very superficial. There is no loss of vision, hardly any pain. The patient only present to you with complaints of redness, which is very superficial. No pain, no decrease in vision. No decrease in vision. And here you have a lot of pain and you have redness. It may be accompanied by a decrease in vision. It's a deep inflammation. Now friends, both of them are more commonly seen in females. Both of them. Okay? Both of them are more commonly seen in females. you may have association of which disorder, which systemic disorder? Rheumatoid arthritis and other connective tissue disorders. Okay? So, rheumatoid arthritis, other connective tissue disorders are seen. I've added this question because we didn't discuss the topic during the class. Episcleritis and scleritis we never discussed, so that's why I have put a question intentionally so that you come to know what can be asked. Okay, so how do you treat? This is mostly self-limiting. Another question, mostly it is self-limiting, and here you have to give steroids, which may be systemic also. Okay. Now another expected new question is, there is a T sign on ultrasound. Scleritis. In scleritis, you see a T sign on ultrasound. That's it, you have to learn. T sign on ultrasound. So which ultrasound I would like to do here? A A scan or B scan? B scan. A scan is only for axial length measurement. Okay, so rest everything will do with B scan. Okay. So ocular complications are more common as compared to scleritis. This is the false statement. Yeah, important. Hanji, 24. You must be knowing iris Bombay is most commonly seen in ring sinai. Okay, very good. Why not total posterior? I hope you have not ratified this question. Have you understood what is it or not? Ratliya. Answer is ring sinai. Now friends, look at this picture which I am drawing here. Look at the picture. Normally the condition is this, normal. Now when you have posterior sinai means adhesions between your iris and lens. Okay, there are adhesions between your iris and lens. Please see, posterior sinai could be anywhere. It could be here, it could be anywhere with the lens. But if these sinai develop only at the pupil with lens, what will happen? Iris will be stuck to lens only at the pupil, not everywhere. Everywhere, if iris and lens are stuck to each other, it will result in a total posterior sinai. Angle closure to bache, isme bhi hoega. Eventually, there will be a angle closure. Why? Because there is a pupillary block. Please see, please look here. Dekho, when there is a ring sinai, ring means that adhesions are developed in between iris and lens at the pupil, 360 degree. Ring ban gayi na, ring. Yahan se khula hai, ye open hai. This is open. This is not touching the lens. The touch of iris and lens is only at the pupil, which is shown by black here. Are you clear? Now when this happens, obviously later on there will be an angle closure. Why? Again, there is a pupillary block. The aqueous will be collected in posterior chamber. It will be pushing the iris towards the angle, and later on there is an angle closure. Have you understood? Total posterior sinai will be something like this. Dekho idhar. That lens is totally stuck everywhere to the lens. Lens is stuck everywhere to the iris. This will be your total posterior sinai. Okay? Now this is not going to lead to iris Bombay. Iris Bombay is nothing but the configuration of iris when there is a ring sinai. What is iris Bombay? It's the shape of the iris which appears when there is a ring sinai. And what is ring sinai? Adhesion of iris and lens at the pupil only, not everywhere. Okay? Have you understood little? Glaucoma will be there in both the situations, but iris Bombay will be only there because of ring sinai, not total posterior sinai. Please understand this question. Now what is a festooned pupil? What is a festoon? Okay, so characteristic pupil in acute uveitis is what? A small irregular pupil. It's not festooned which is characteristic. It's a small irregular pupil which you see in acute uveitis. Now when you dilate this pupil, it results in a festooned pupil. Okay? Irregular dilatation of the pupil because of sinecae. Because of sinecae. This is festooned. Characteristic pupil in acute uveitis is a small irregular pupil. This is important. When you dilate it, by the way, why do you dilate it? What is the role of cycloplegic mydriatics here? The first role is primary role. Yes, that's the primary role to break the ciliary muscle spasm, relaxes the ciliary muscle, relieve the pain, decrease the pain of the patient. This is the primary objective. Okay? The second, what he said, prevents sinecae formation, and third, to break already formed sinecae. All of them are important, but the primary objective is release spasm of the muscle. Clear? This is also a question. What is the primary objective? What is not the objective? Okay? Good. So, if you have acute uveitis patient, the IOP high. If the patient is developing a glaucoma, obviously the IOP will be high. Hena? How would you like to treat that IOP with which drug? Who said pilocarpine? Pilocarpine is absolutely contraindicated. Okay? Pupil पहले से ही छोटा है ना और छोटा करोगे and pilocarpine incites a lot of inflammation. Pilocarpine is also absolutely contraindicated. What else can you give? Latanoprost is also contraindicated. Yes. So timolol is a safe drug.